So let's go into your reading. The first thing that the first cluster deals with the Fool and the Queen of Swords. So first of all, I want to talk about the Fool first. This is a card about new beginnings, embarking on a journey of learning, of self-discovery, discovering yourself, your capabilities, your potential, where you are supposed to be in the world, as well as discovering, things that about the world through interactions with other people. What I'm also feeling is, for some of you, I feel that you are embarking on a new phase in your life. This can be either on the career front or just, new ways of like behaving in a specific environment. So I feel like a lot of you had to, like in the past, you were always the helpful person, the one that, come to everybody else's rescue. I feel like one of the major changes in personality or, coping mechanisms that you're going to have to learn for this month, especially, and going through the rest of the year, is how to protect your own boundaries and how to, be a lot more objective and a lot more critical. And now Virgos, it's a critical sign. You are quite picky. However, I feel like this is playing out in a different way, where you have to be discerning and critical of what is being said. And I feel like not because, not because it's innate, but because I feel like in order to do your job or in order to do something really well, you are going to have to be like a little bit more investigative. You can't take things at face value. You have to dig a little bit deeper and you have to ask these pertinent questions in order to flush out the truth. Okay. So I feel there's that element circling around you where you are no longer naive. You're becoming a lot more objective. You're growing up in the process, and your ability to discern a lie or discern, the truth from lies, that's going to be very, very important for you in some areas of your life. This can be personal, or it can be professional. Okay, and I feel like it might be both for both of you because we do have a habit of learning skills that can help us through all areas of life, not just one nicely compartmentalized area. So I feel like it's a maturation process. It's an emotional process. It might be a little bit difficult for some of you to like learn to detach yourself from a specific situation, to look at it objectively, to not control outcomes, and to do the best that you can given the circumstances. And having to give up the fact that, we can perform miracles overnight. So I hope that makes sense. What I feel is like in the past, you might have been very, very perfectionistic. You were striving for a specific outcome, and you feel like if I just put all the work, all of my energy into it, I'm going to make it to the best that it can possibly be. And I feel like, the reality sets in, and you might realize that sometimes perfection is not like an achievable goal, and striving for perfection is just not something that we can do and expend our energy and expect to come to fruition. So I feel like realistic expectations versus, idealistic expectations, those are the two opposing energies coming through. And I feel like in the past you might have felt like I'm ready to settle for those, realistic expectations, and you feel like a part of you loses as a result of settling for it. But I feel that this is a maturation process where you are realizing that some things, given the constraints, given the environment, we do the best that we can and hope for the best. And controlling for a specific outcome, aiming for perfection might not be realistic. Okay, so there is definitely maturation in the way that you think, in the way that you approach problem solvings, and in the ways that you interact with people. And I feel it's positive. What else is coming through here is a lot of you are dealing with an air sign, an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libra. And I feel like this is a person who is very, very, very decisive. Once they make up their mind about something, they don't really fluctuate. They don't really change, and they're quite stubborn. And I feel like you know that they're headed towards a troublesome situation, and you're trying your best to give them counsel. And a part of you want to prevent them from some type of detrimental outcome. And a part of you wants to warn them, but I feel that, a big part of you also believes that, they are living their lives and they need to make their mistakes in order to learn, in order to grow. So I feel like a lot of you want to get involved, but you're holding back, mainly because you don't want to interfere with other people's karma. And if this sounds familiar, if this sounds familiar and you feel like, should I or should I not intervene? The thing here is that, we have to like learn to love other people with detachment, okay? And it's really important to learn because we cannot interfere in other people's karma, karmic lessons especially. Some things need to be played out in order for the person that's going through it to truly learn it and to truly absorb that lesson. So I feel like you're on the threshold of wanting to intervene, but it's not within your power to do so, and it's not going to be wise for you to do so. So boundary issues, once again, boundaries is not just about keeping people out, but it's also about, where do I fit in, where do I start and where do others start? Where do I end and where do others begin? So these things are coming through, and I feel like it's coming through with somebody that you really care about. This can be a friend, this can be a colleague, this can be just somebody that you are romantically involved with as well. I also feel like there is a voyage, a trip, somebody is coming through to see you as well, and it might be an air sign, an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libra. And I feel like you are picking their brain mainly because they are very objective and very detached. And I feel that vice versa, some of you, it could be the other way where you are having trouble with objectivity and they're giving you a dose of a reality check, okay? Not in a bad way. I feel like they're giving out advice. And I do sense as well travel, someone coming to see you coming to see somebody else. There is an exchange of like best practices, there is an exchange of ideas and counsel and advice. Okay, now the second cluster here deals with some really, really karmic stuff. And first of all, we have here the Six of Pentacles and the Six of Swords. One of the first thing that I, the sixes, especially the Six of Pentacles, I always think of it as like karma. Good or bad karma, this is kind of like the reaping of, reaping what you sow. And I all honestly feel like for a lot of you, especially those of you who are in the service sector, who are working in some capacity as a person who serves other people. So that can be a civil servant, that can be, in the public sector, or you're in some capacity where you are helping people in some way in the helping profession. I feel that there's this element here of, sailing over troubled waters and helping other people navigate, a very dire situation that they couldn't do on their own. So if you can recall within the past like 6 years or so, if you have been helping people in that capacity, I feel like you're going to be handsomely rewarded, okay? This is not to say that, if you haven't been doing that you're off track. I just feel like karma coming back home to roost sometime for the month of November. And I feel like especially if you have been kind of like the guiding hand, helping somebody navigate through some really tenuous situation, I feel that, the thanks, the accolades, the appreciation is coming back through for you. And at the same time, I feel like there is such a thing as a universal, rebalancing act where whatever work that you're doing, if you're working very, very diligently, you are going to be handsomely rewarded. I do see promotions. I do see pay increases with the Six of Pentacles. And I feel that, you're going to overcome your financial worries if that has been something that's plaguing you. And you feel like you work very hard, but you feel like you're not being adequately compensated. There is going to be some type of a rebalancing of that karmic scale in your favor, I feel. So that's what's coming through as well. And the Six of Pentacles is a card about generosity. It's a card about like giving alms, like helping people who are less fortunate than us. So there's an element here where you are going to have to step up for this month. to take charge of a situation and help somebody that is less fortunate than yourself, either monetarily or even, with counsel, with advice, or with a means to better their lives in some way. Okay, so whatever you do, just know that you will be rewarded handsomely. So this is just, do things out of the kindness of our hearts. We do things not because we want compensation, but I feel like it's coming through. So in whatever capacity that is, I feel that it's going to be good for you. I'm also sensing that this is a good month if you have like children and you want to do some type of community service, or you feel like, what's a good activity for me to do with the kids, tomorrow? And you're kind of like out of ideas. Take them to do some type of community service, mainly because I'm seeing the tower here. So I feel like some things can be navigated around, and this might be a good start. So do some type of, if you have children, if you are thinking about fostering children, if you are thinking about fostering pets or something like that, some good deeds, I feel it's really going to be helpful for this month, okay? So I do feel that might be something that you want to look into if you're interested. Mainly because I do feel that it's going to buffer the effects somewhat. It's going to buffer that, okay? So going through the third cluster here, we do have the Two of Pentacles as well as the Strength card. And the Two of Pentacles basically indicates, oh, also, let me backtrack a little bit. I apologize, but this is one last message coming through here. A lot of you might be taking out loans, property for repairs or to, refinance a property with this tower here. So I feel that, if you're waiting on some decision, whether or not to sell your property or whether or not some loans, some money coming through from a financial institution or from a governmental institution is going to come through, I do feel that the answer is yes. And I do feel that it's going to help you navigate over some trouble spots within your financial life. I do feel there's an element here of 2 months before things sorting themselves out and smoothing themselves out. So it's still going to be a little bit of a wait, but I feel that you're going to sail over it, okay? So moving on to the third cluster here, we do have the Two of Pentacles as well as the Strength card. The Two of Pentacles indicates a situation where we are juggling. This can be personal, private life, or professional life. And that balance, that kind of like trying to keep things spinning, trying to keep things afloat. And this can also indicate a situation where job offers are on the table and you are trying to decide which one to go with, or you are trying to make ends meet by having two jobs, juggling two jobs. And I feel like it's a situation where they're telling you things are going to get better. So hang in there just a little bit more. Don't give up on it and don't jump the gun and decide on anything right now, because I feel like what initially seems like a great decision, like if you're choosing between two things and the first thing that jumped out at you, I feel like you're going to have a change of heart towards the middle or towards the end of the month. And I feel like, it seems great right now because you might want a way out. But there's something better coming through. So, it's kind of like that irony where you should, good things come to those who wait, and you should try to wait it out just a little bit longer if you can for a better opportunity to come through that you might not initially, anticipate or expect the first time around. The Strength card is also a card about, it's like coaxing. It's essentially manipulating a situation to your favor, but doing so in a way where whoever you're dealing with also sees what you see and also sees the benefits to what you're doing. So what I sense is that for a lot of you, you're dealing with somebody who is very, very, very stubborn, very fixed in their ways, very just like, their minds are already made up about everything. That's what I'm feeling. You might be dealing with this air sign, Aquarius, Gemini, and Libra. And one of the tricks is, you're trying to convince them of a specific, to see your side of the argument. And they're telling you, rather than going head to head, the smarter thing to do is to coax them, to provide some type of narrative so that It's relatable to them so that they understand, where you're coming from, and it doesn't antagonize them. It doesn't, escalate the tension within the interaction. So they're telling you, find a different way to get people to see from your point of view, and it's going to require a little bit of thinking outside the box. But you're going to get whatever you want through, gently coaxing somebody rather than being confrontational. So keep tempers in check, and like let people talk, and then feel where they're coming from. Okay, so I feel like a lot of it has to do with just, sitting in silence or sitting and let the other person just talk. And then see what comes out, and then see, where, what angle you can spin a story or what angle you can approach them at in order to get them to see things from your point of view. All right. Now, the last cluster deals with the Chariot and the Tower. The Chariot is a very, very good card. This is a card about winning. It's a card about victory. It's a card about triumph over, a lot of self-doubt and self like, I feel like whatever the Chariot card usually indicates, like whatever that has been blocked is now, all systems go. So whatever that was held up in your life, whatever legal issues or legal counsel you had to navigate around, whatever breaches of personal space that you've had to contend with within the past few years, things are starting to clear up for a lot of you. And a lot of you are leaving, one place of living for another. A lot of you might need to do some physical repairs within the household, and you're running back and forth trying to, find contractors, or trying to find like the best rates, or even trying to find parts so that you can do it yourself. I would advise to try to look at specialists in order to fix things that you're not too familiar with, because I don't feel that it's going to work out well for do-it-yourself projects on things that are important, such as plumbing or electrical work. Okay, that's you need a specialist for those things. And what I'm also feeling as well is I feel like there's a lot of change movement happening for you. And in the past, I feel like a lot of you might have waited for situations to get better. And this is the month in which you're like, I'm not waiting anymore. I'm going to take charge of my life. And I feel like that's great energy. And I feel like it takes, a lot for an earth sign to finally move and get things started on their own. It takes a lot. And I feel that, all this waiting in the past, you're tired of it and you're moving forward. And I feel that the universe is supporting this move, because I do sense that you're leaving some things behind. And you're moving on to a better space. And a lot of you, if you are tra if you are like changing jobs as well, the new job, it seems to me like there's a lot of traveling involved. I don't feel like it's overseas. I feel like it's local. And I feel like there's communication from overseas as well, or further away, but the geographical zone that you are traveling around for the new job is not going to be that far, okay? I'm also feeling like institutions for some reason with this card. It's a tower, but I think like it's a guard tower. It seems like, something about guarding, something about, a watchtower, something about, having this bird's eye view, and you see everything that's happening below, and you're kind of like able to help people navigate some very tricky situation, and they might not see, the forest for the trees, but you're able to guide them. You're able to direct them to where they're supposed to be. So, the energy is very positive. Okay, so I saw the Tower card, so I pulled out three cards here. And first of all, we do have here the Seven of Swords in the reverse. Be very careful about, vehicle issues, your car being broken into. Don't park it in a dangerous neighborhood. Do not leave purses, money in clear view in the car. Just be careful about that, because I do see theft here. This is a card about sneaky energy, like leaving things behind, leaving a paper trail, or even like overlooking a certain situation, trusting somebody that had no business, trusting. So I feel like, going back to what I mentioned, the environment that you're moving into, the vibrational energy is very low. So you might encounter, you know, like it might be an area with a lot of crime, with high poverty rates, for example, where people have to commit crimes of opportunities. And, you know, people have to do all kinds of things to survive. So this is not a judgment call, but it's more about, you know, watching your back. And be careful about cars and don't leave, you know, purses and things behind in the car when you lock up for the night, okay? I have as well the Four of Cups in the reverse position. And I feel like what it's telling me is you might be dealing with some people who are very, very manipulative here. So it seems almost as if they know how to work a system is what I'm getting. They know how to get around things to get exactly what they want. And they know how to, they know all the tricks in the books. And I feel like that's why going head to head is going to aggravate the situation. So you need to find like a better way to, you know, play on their emotions and pretend like you're on their team. So I feel there's this undercurrent of manipulation going back and forth. I don't feel like it's done in a malicious way, but I feel like it's done in a very, very politically, I would say like stealthy way. It's done in a very diplomatic but also stealthy way, okay? So that's the people that's in your environment that you might need to deal with. And there's a lot of office politics and things like that involved. But underneath it is kind of like this layer of like a mixture of diplomacy and mixture of cunning. And that's what you're going to need to do in order to do your job or in order to, you know, successfully work in this environment, all right? What's coming through in terms of your spiritual advice, and I really like this card because this is the card of Virgo. It is the Hermit. It is somebody with a lot of wisdom, with a lot of insight, and also with a lot of spiritual guidance in order to give you, you know, that bird's eye view of a situation in order for you to see it very, very clearly. So, first of all, I feel like this is the energy that you are embodying, one of the Hermit, okay? We have here the Nine of Pentacles, and the Nine of Pentacles traditionally indicates like a person that is, you know, a business owner, a self-employed person, someone who is very, very financially well off. And I do feel there are going to be business ventures that you, if you are thinking about opening up your own business, there is a fire sign here, a Sagittarius, a Sagittarius, a Leo or an Aries, sun, moon or rising that you are potentially coming to for business ventures, for advice regarding business ventures, or somebody's thinking about wanting you to partner up with them in order to start something. And I feel like it is a very, very fruitful business relationship if that's something that will come to fruition, because I feel that, you know, there's a sense of loyalty. There's a sense of like, it's a good complementarity between you and this other person. So I feel that it can work out. It can be very financially lucrative as well, okay? The other thing about this Queen of Rods here, and I feel like if you are embodying this energy, what I really want to say is that it seems almost as if like you, this month for a lot of you, you're embodying this energy of a very, very like playful, adventurous spirit. And make sure you keep that in check, because you know with the Fool card, the Fool is like the first major arcana in the deck, so he does not know where he's going. And he's still, you know, he's childlike and innocent, but he might need some guidance. So I feel like, you know, on the one hand, you want to be, you want to like grab opportunities, but on the other hand, it's telling you to slow down a little bit and assess the situation very clearly. Do some preliminary research before you dabble into a new venture.